Fast forward 100 years, and we see the same pattern. While the typical American's wages barely budged for decades, adjusted for inflation, most economic gains have gone to the top. Just as Eccles's so-called giant suction pump drew an increasing portion of the nation's wealth into a few hands before the Great Depression. The result has been an economy whose underlying structure is far more fragile than it may seem. Remember the housing and financial debt bubbles that burst in 2008? We avoided another Great Depression then, only because the government pumped enough money into the economy to maintain demand, and the Fed kept interest rates near zero. And then came the pandemic. The Fed has had to keep interest rates near zero, and the government has had to pump even more money into the economy. While these programs have been crucial to staving off a pandemic-induced depression, they're only temporary. Over the long term, the real worry continues to be on the demand side. Widening inequality means not enough demand. America's wealth gap is now more extreme than it's been in over a century. Until this structural problem is remedied, the American economy will remain perilously fragile. It will also be vulnerable to the next demagogue, wielding anger and racism and resentment as substitutes for real reform. Closing our staggering wealth gap is crucial to the survival of both our economy and our democracy.